Hey, Doc. I never exactly thanked you for pulling me out of cryo.
I wasn't convinced you felt I had done you a favor.
Well, I guess I prefer being conscious, regardless of the circumstances.
Not everyone would agree. But you do seem particularly well-suited to these times, Outrider.
What exactly were you and Jane doing out there anyway, when you found me?
Scavenging tech in the old ruins. I honestly thought I'd scoured half the planet, but I had recently found an old notebook of my father's. In it, he described those first months on the Flores floating over Enoch, how the landing had been delayed, and the anxiety about sending the Outriders down.
Anxiety? What do you mean? Outriders were always meant to go down first.
Yes, but if, as it turned out, the planet didn't end up proving exactly habitable, there was no plan to get you back up to the Flores. You were sent on a one-way trip.
Yeah, they never told us that part, but it's not surprising. And shit, that explains why Maxwell was calling in the green light no matter what.
Anyway, I'd never heard the story. And it suddenly occurred to me, this Maxwell who called in the green light, he must have had a way to contact the Flores. An uplink. There had to be an uplink on this first drop pod, and if I could find it...
And you did. Your briefcase. That's Maxwell's uplink in there. The world's last hope. How fucking poetic. Jack Tanner's daughter, Sarah. It seems she took his place in leading what was left of the Outriders.
She was one of the few that fought back when the ECA had the Outriders court-martialed. She saved many Outriders' lives. But she disappeared after that, didn't leave a trace.
Seems this bunker's where she ended up. Her last entry says she walked off into the forest in search of her husband and son.
By herself? She could have been hoping to survive.
None of us came into this hoping to survive. If anything, she died doing what the Outriders were meant to do, pushing into the unknown, past the frontier, finishing her tour of duty on her feet, as the Outriders used to say.
You bunch really did come from a different time.
Hold up! Movement in the trees behind us, it's Kang!
Probably wants his revenge.
He can get in line.
Kang has followed us far enough. Time I finished this.
Kang may talk a big game, but don't count on him showing up. He'd rather leave the dirty work to his fighters.
Well, that gives me something to look forward to. I'll be back after I deal with these assholes.
Thank you.
Sarah Tanner, you made us proud. Outrider till the end. Zahidi, I found Sarah Tanner. She made it further than any other expedition. Tough, like her dad. The final key. Time I paid that bunker one more visit. Tiago, you were right. Kang didn't show his face.
He won't. Until he can be sure the odds are in his favor.
Well, that's never gonna happen. Don't let your guard down. I'll scout the road to that gate up ahead.
Look, I know Kang's type and his guys. Mercs who've lost their mission. Left with fuck all to do but plunder and slaughter or risk turning on each other. I'll tell you, I am not happy about having to look over my shoulder for Kang wherever we go.
Hey, Doc. Something that's been driving me crazy. Can you explain to me how we're still able to use radios when the anomaly distorts the signal, our probes, anything long range?
That's it exactly. We're using analog shortwave radio on a high frequency band without a lot of power, which means we can communicate over short distances. A digital signal like the one we're tracking has a far greater range and is less prone to interference. Still, over a large enough distance, the anomaly will distort it.
So, as long as the anomaly's around, we're stuck with analog.
Analog equipment is far more resistant to the electromagnetic fluctuations caused by the anomaly. It's one thing our forefathers on Earth did right.
Thank you. Whatever they were defending, we're almost in. Zahidi, the Outriders were stockpiling weapons in this bunker. A whole damn lot of them.
How many are we talking?
Enough to hold off the apocalypse. And then some. Well, fuck me. Zahidi, I think I'm staring at a nuke.
A thermonuclear bomb? I wonder Tanner's daughter was willing to give her life to keep that hatch closed. I think it might be very wise to close it again and throw away the key.
Zahidi, something's happening. The machines, they're crashing.
You need to get out of there before it explodes.
Warning, safety controls failing. Missile launch imminent. Warning.
Okay, that's not good. What do I do?
I don't know. You think I know anything about nuclear bombs? Wait. Is there a refrigerator around?
A refrigerator?
Yeah, a fucking refrigerator. You know what a fucking refrigerator
is? Yeah. I found it.
Oh, thank God. Now get inside.
What?
Get inside the refrigerator. The lead will protect you.
That is the stupidest idea I've ever heard.
I saw it somewhere.
That's not gonna happen.
Countdown to launch initiated.
Oh, fuck.
Launch
wait.
In T-minus. 120.
Okay.
119.
There's a slot for the key.
117.
Listen to me. You've got to move fast. You've got company. Insurgents just rushed the hatch.
113. 112.
Well, that's just great.
make it!
5, 4,
fuck!
3,
mother!
2, 1. Missile launch sequence aborted. Have a nice day.
Yeah. It's over. Zahidi, you got any ideas where we might hide some keys?